The coral reef, one of the richest and most complex natural ecosystems on Earth. It is home to some of the most extraordinary marine life in the world, and the beauty of coral reefs is enjoyed by many. However, coral reefs have suffered with the increase of human-induced alteration of water composition. The issue of sedimentation is an increasingly recurring problem in these vibrant ecosystems, leaving reef beds desolate. Sediment deposition, in its purest form, is a natural phenomenon caused by monsoons and the natural water flow of currents. Terrigenous sedimentation, however, has increasingly stressed reef ecosystems with the increased production of synthesized pollutants. Sedimentation adversely affects the propagation of corals by inhibiting exposure to sunlight when sediment is suspended in water. Sediment can also smother the corals and increase the propagation of algae in the ecosystem. There are two main causes of sedimentation. One is natural, and the other is enabled by humans. The thunderclouds merge into a vast circle. A hurricane is born. Viewed from high above, a hurricane is the essence of nature's fury. At any one moment, it is generating as much energy as the world's entire electrical output. The storm's destructive power will allow us to see sedimentation at its worst. Threats to reefs from sedimentation and pollution from inland sources is just as much of a threat to reefs as hurricanes. Large river flood events during the wet season are washing sediment into the ocean, which is having a significant impact on water quality around the reef. Human waste deposited into inland streams end up decomposing into sediments, which ultimately are deposited into the ocean. The already detrimental effect of sediment is compounded by the contaminants of dissolved organic matter and climate change, thus exponentially increasing the phenomena's effect on coral reefs. In years with much monsoonal rainfall, large freshwater flood plumes carrying sediment, nutrients, other pollutants, and debris from the mainland enter the coastal zone and may reach out to the outer reefs of the Great Barrier Reef, threatening vulnerable corals. As seen in the videos, rivers are constantly flowing into the ocean, which means this is a constant threat as opposed to the unpredictability of hurricanes. During the hurricane, corals face the unrelenting force of high winds and strong waves crashing upon the reef. This force will not only undoubtedly physically devastate corals, but will also lay a thick layer of residue from the ocean's foundation on top of them. This residue smothers corals to death by blocking out the sun, thus preventing the Cymbiodinium from photosynthesizing and therefore eradicating the coral's main source of nutrients. Some corals can unbury themselves when submerged in sediment. As seen in the time-lapse displayed, the complex method of escape employed by fungid corals is truly fascinating. These corals actively shed the sediment with a very controlled series of movements. However, if a coral is unlucky enough to not have this ability, then it will usually die in a few days, given the amount of organic waste in the sediment.
Human activities on land, such as the clearing of forests, road building, and other development, can lead to increased rates of sedimentation.
High loads of sedimentation can reduce light penetration and reduce the photosynthetic activity of zooxanthellae.
The problem of sedimentation of coral reefs has been increased by the removal of mangrove and seagrass communities that naturally filter out sediment. The problem of sedimentation of coral... Human activities on land, such as the clearing of forests, road building, and other development, can lead to The problem of sedimentation of coral reefs has been increased by the removal of mangrove and seagrass communities that naturally filter out sediment.